Kristen here. Welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to talk about my top 5 favorite YA fantasy and sci-fi books. This is part of Top 5 Wednesday. If you are not familiar, Top 5 Wednesday is a Goodreads group. Every Wednesday there is a new topic and it is our job to come up with the books, sometimes movies and TV, but usually books that fit whatever that theme is. And this week's theme is your favorite fantasy and science fiction books. So for readers that read a lot of different genres, it's probably fun to compile your favorite fantasy and sci-fi books. But for me, who reads 90% fantasy and sci-fi books, this was nearly an impossible task. So, first of all, I'm gonna cheat. I'm gonna give you my 5 books, but I'm also gonna let you know books that didn't make the list. And secondly, I had to narrow this down to YA books. I actually started as a book blogger and read almost exclusively adult, and then I grew to love YA books, and that's what I've been into now. So I'm gonna stick with the YA books, although I could make my top 20 favorite adult fantasy and sci-fi books for you if you ask me to. Before we get started, if you have not subscribed to my channel yet, please go ahead and do that. Hit that subscribe button. At the end of the video, if you enjoyed the video, give it a like or leave me a comment in the comment section to let me know. And don't forget to hit that bell next to the subscribe button so you get a notification next time I post a new video. I will also leave a link in the description section below to Whimsify. If you don't know, I am the owner of a brand new YA fantasy and sci-fi book subscription box called Whimsify. If you are interested in getting some more information and a special discount code for when our subscription page goes live, follow the link in the description section and add your email and join the Whimsify family. Keep an eye out for when our page launches very soon. The first box will be shipping out in mid-April. I always have information about my social media in the description section, but I will also leave information about Whimsify's social media in case you're interested in following me any of those places to get some more insight on what's going on with the Whimsify box. Alright, these are not in any particular order. This is not a countdown from 5 to 1. I could not even begin to try to put these in order. Alright, so first on this list, I am going to go with a book by Marissa Meyer, and I really had a hard time with this. At first, I really wanted to go with Heartless. This was one of my favorite YA fantasy books that I have ever read. I absolutely adored this book. But I ended up going with a Lunar Chronicles book instead. There's so many more books in that series. I feel like I know the world and the characters better. I narrowed it down to Cress and Cinder, and I kept going back and forth, and I finally went with Cress. Cress is one of my all-time favorite YA science fiction books. This entire series is phenomenal. If you've watched my other videos on this channel, you know that I go on and on about the Lunar Chronicles series. It's one of my favorites, and I highly recommend it if you're into audiobooks. It's narrated by a phenomenal narrator. It's just a really great series, and Cress is my favorite of our little group of 4 girls, and her love interest, Captain Thorn, is by far one of my all-time favorite YA love interests. Male characters, whatever you want to call him. He's clever, he's funny, he's loyal. I just love the two of them together. So, first on the list, going with Cress. Okay, next on this list, and again, no particular order, I was having a hard time deciding between Vampire Academy and Bloodlines. Again, 2 phenomenal series by the same author. I absolutely love both of them. They're both similar in that the fantasy element here is mostly vampires and a little bit of other magic. But between the two, believe it or not, I actually went with Bloodlines. And that's because I read these a little bit more recently, and I really love Sydney and Adrian. I actually loved Adrian in Vampire Academy. I was Team Adrian more than Team Dimitri, although I think Rose ended up with the right guy in Vampire Academy. I was really glad to see Adrian get a spinoff, and so that kind of edged this out a little more for me. I know that's shocking. I know a lot of you are not going to agree with that decision. If you've been reading fantasy books for a while, Vampire Academy is like one of the OGs. This is honestly probably not my favorite book in the series. It's just the only one I have in print. And I would probably say, I think it is the 3rd book or 4th book when we finally get some like tumultuous romance between Sydney and Adrian. So whichever book that is, I want to say the 3rd book. That is definitely my favorite book, whichever one that is. Okay, my next choice actually gave me the same problem as the first two. There were 2 great series that were spin-offs of each other by the same author, and that is Cassandra Clare, the Mortal Instruments series, and the Infernal Devices series. And I am actually going to go with the Infernal Devices series. This trilogy is one of my all-time favorite YA fantasy books. Hands down, love it more than the Mortal Instruments. Fight me over it. I love this series. The emotion in this series, Woo! If you are a fan of love triangles, and a lot of people are not anymore, keep in mind that this trilogy is complete. It's been out for a few years now. But if you are a fan of love triangles and you love to hate them and you love to read about all of the emotion and heartbreak and love that happens in a love triangle in a YA book, this is so the series for you. The Mortal Instruments has a lot of different romances happening throughout it, and don't get me wrong, I do love that series. When I read the Infernal Devices trilogy, I was just blown away by how into the characters I was. I love Will and Jem, the two love interests for the main character, Tessa. I love both of them so much that I went back and forth like every couple of chapters with which person I wanted her to end up with. And some people hate the way this trilogy ends. I actually really love the way the trilogy ends. I could not see it ending any other way. So if you like the Mortal Instruments and you haven't like gone out to this trilogy yet, I highly recommend it. I also love that it's like turn of the century London. It's a different setting than the Mortal Instruments, which is super, super cool. I have not read the new books. I know that they're based on a relative of a main character in this trilogy. So this is definitely an important trilogy to check out if you are a Shadowhunters fan. Okay, next I have a YA sci-fi, and finally, not a difficult decision for me, that is Gemina by Amy Kaufman and Jay Kristoff. I have Illuminae and Gemina, but I went with Gemina just because I feel like we get to see like all the characters in this one, and I felt like it moved a little bit faster, and I was just like deeper in the world at this point, but I just really, really love Gemina. I liked it a little bit more than Illuminae, so this is such a freaking unique book. If you haven't read these books and you keep hearing about it, like go into a bookstore or a Target book section or anywhere that you see this book and flip through it. The text is super unique. It's, gosh, I'm not even showing you good pages. Like, it's got regular text in it, but it also has like the story told in this, I don't know, really unique format. And I didn't think that I was really gonna like that, so I held off reading it for a while. Such a bad choice. These books are phenomenal. Reading in that different format makes the reads really quick, even though this is like the biggest book ever. But yeah, super fast paced, super interesting, great characters to root for. Highly recommend. All right, my last pick for my top five favorite YA fantasy and sci-fi books is another one that I'm gonna cheat a little bit for. This is not two series by the same author that I couldn't decide between. It was just picking the correct book in the series, and that is the Throne of Glass series by Sarah J. Maas. If you've been watching my channel, you know that I did a marathon read of these books over a few months and caught up to the release Empire of Storms in the fall. And I absolutely love this series. I cannot believe it took me so long to read them. I was so sad after I read Empire of Storms, knowing that I didn't have another one to read for a while, and I do still have the Court of Thorn and Roses books to catch up on, so thank goodness I have a little bit more Sarah J. Maas to read. But in this series, the first book is actually not my favorite. I actually have a bit of a tie between Crown of Midnight and Queen of Shadows. I love both of these books for different reasons. I really loved Crown of Midnight because I feel like it was a lot more emotional. We got to see Selena and Kaol together, and I am Team Kaol till I die, till the end, go down in flames, I don't care, Kaol, what's up? And this book was very, very Kaol heavy, so I really enjoyed it. Plus, there was a very, very emotional point in this book. If you've read it, you know what I'm talking about. Very, very big scene that happened, and it kind of spurs on the whole rest of the series from this book forward. So I feel like this was a really big, big, big important book. Plus, at the end of this book, a huge, huge, huge secret is revealed. So I don't know, this just felt like such a hefty and important book in the series, and it was so emotional. I remember staying up till like 3 or 4 in the morning just to finish this book. Queen of Shadows was probably like my favorite to read. There's a lot more Rowan in this one, but there's a lot more Manon and a lot more Lysandra, and I really love Manon and I love Lysandra, and I feel like so many pieces came together in this one. So many things like clicked into place, and this is also like a really big, thick, hefty book. So this was probably the one that took me the longest to read, so I was the most attached to it. Okay, that is it. Those are my really, really difficult to decide top five favorite YA fantasy and sci-fi books. There were a lot of books that I had on my list when I first started playing this out that I couldn't get them all into the top five, even with cheating. As always, thank you guys for watching, and I will see you soon with a new video. Bye.